I don't know if they got me stabbing you with the pen there.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. My timing is not good today. Over here. Senil. Both these guys, such intensity in their faces. Mm. Down here on the bottom left from the site teamliquid.net.
Liquid Chinro.
This is, people have to remember. Jinro. All right.
Jinroffle nerd stumped.
Oh, God, I don't want to do it.
Accepted ertosis. Yeah. Try to accept it before it destroys you.
Thank you for that. You know, you got to, as you said, they both look so intense and everything. People have to remember that these are actual pro gamers. These two are humans who make their entire living. It is based around winning StarCraft II games. And
yeah, I mean, the pressure is on.
This is so important.
You know, I think I was talking to a friend of mine about this. But, you know, sometimes people on TV, whether even if it's a commentator, in this case a pro gamer, oftentimes people view viewers tend to view those people more like ideas and not like actual people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's a human being over there, man. There's a lot of pressure on here.
Oh,
I mean,
absolutely.
That's why people want to watch sports or anything, is because they want to see the human struggle. Humans pitch against other humans. There are always going to be winners. There are always going to be losers.
There are. And, you know, I can't even explain how stressful it is for these guys to lose games here. If you fall down to Code A, Code S is the biggest stage in the world. If you're in Code S, even if you're not, like, doing perfectly, even if you go to up and down matches and get out, you're in Code S, man. You're a contender. You're one of the best players in the world. But when you fall to Code A, it is a long way back to Code S.
And, you know, the thing about Code S is really what Code S is you're the best. Code A is somebody who's just trying to get into Code S.
Yeah. There's not a lot of prize money. I mean, a lot of times it affects their careers, whether they're in it or not.
So absolutely.
Xeno this time, finding the pattern of Jinro, a lot of bunker rushes, goes for a speed first build.
Now, it does look like, let's see here, Terran has taken, could you get a shot of the Terran main from here, Joseph?
Sure.
Just for our
sending
his
extra SCVs.
So he's going to do the same rush, okay.
Yep, it's going to be six SCVs and a bunch of Marines once again. But this time, we do have speed. He did make a drone extra.
Uh-oh. Now, this certainly could get up there, but he is instead going to try to soften up these Marines. Now, a lot of this is going to come down to control, as said before. He's going to make a bunker right there, and I see the Marine could actually get behind it in this little nook. And another bunker at the upper left.
I like this.
A third bunker. It's bunker madness.
Certainly is. He's going to have to make a move quickly here, Tasteless. Xenio's going to be quite upset. It's going to be an awkward ride home if he loses all his games of bunker rushes.
Yeah, no kidding.
And speed finishes. The Zerglings start hitting on the Marines. He's got to kill them all, Tasteless, because if a bunker finishes... Uh-oh!
They got in.
Two of them get in. Jinro breathes a huge sigh of relief, no doubt.
But the game's not over yet. Don't forget, Jinro lost. The game looked very similar to this.
So what we're going to see right now is Xenio cutting off reinforcements.
Cancel. Oh, my God.
I don't know if I cancel. I think what he needs to do is...
Serious?
He has 12 wings popping out, fully surround the bunker so it can't be repaired, and kill it. Last second. Here he goes.
I think he should cancel that.
His last Zerglings did not pop out in time.
Yeah, that was a mistake.
That was close timing, though, man.
All right. Jinro's already sold everything off.
And here's the thing. Jinro spent a lot to get rid of that. He lost six SCVs in that. How many drones were lost? Zero. Just Zerglings. So
that is a good point, Artosis.
18 drones to 15 SCVs, 23 Zerglings. They're not going to be able to break through.
Will he transition into Banelings?
I think he should
just expand again.
Yeah. Because, yes, he lost the hatchery, and that sucks, yeah. But he's not that far behind.
Well,
he's got more drones.
You know what? You make a really cogent argument for that right now, because when I was watching, I was thinking, oh, the hatchery, oh, no. But don't you think he should have at least canceled the hatchery? And not if, even then, he would have actually just got most of his money back. I see this.
Yeah.
I guess what I'm saying is, I see the strategy he's trying to do, but realistically, since he lost the hatch, it's like...
Well, the Broodlings help out a little bit, but yeah, no, it obviously in this exact case, it would have been better to cancel that. The thing is, yeah, that's very hard to time. He wanted to hit it right before losing, and he almost did. He was off literally by like 1 to 2 seconds on perhaps saving that hatchery with 10 health or something.
Yeah.
So
tough call, no doubt.
It's a very tough call. But yes, theory crafting it, you should have canceled.
He did sell that one bunker. Barracks on the way over here. And I would not be surprised if our game looks surprisingly similar from here on out with Jinro's build from the game that we saw against Coca.
Yeah, I think this is his follow-up for the most part. Well, actually, he's getting two factors this time. All right, and you know why he's getting that? Is he's going to go Blue Flame Hellions.
But you know what?
Xenio
saw everything, including the tech lab.
So he's actually already making a Roach Warren because, you know, he didn't see any Roaches. Obviously, Blue Flame Hellions can be a great idea. General playing very smartly. And right now, we do have 31 drones against 24 SCVs. So Xenio's doing a great job recovering here.
Well, the big question is how many drones can the Terran kill with the Blue Flame Hellions? You know, can he take out some creep tumors?
Interesting.
One thing about Blue Flame Hellions is that you don't want to lose too many of the Blue Flame Hellions. You want to be able to do enough damage. You know, sometimes I see really good players do a brilliant stuff where they bait the roaches out and they go into the main.
Yeah.
But you want to make sure those things do damage before they die out.
Yeah, you don't want to die.
And I like how Zerg's taking the right location on the map.
I love that.
Unexpected
as well.
Location.
Yes. And that's the type of thing you want to do to try to come back a little bit. You know, he's in kind of a weird spot in the game, but that's a good base to take right now. What's interesting to me is that he's going Bantling Nest right now. I think this is because he may be expecting the Marine Hellion timing, which is really, really powerful. And in fact, combat shields are done, so I believe Jinro is going to do that, where he just attacks with a bunch of Marines and Blue Flame Hellions.
Yeah, he just started Stimpak.
So we definitely could see that timing, a starport going up as well. So Jinro preparing for late game.
So these Hellions we used, Jorass, he does not want to lose the Hellions, mind you. He will not throw them away needlessly. What he wants to do is take some Zerglings out, take some Creep Tumors out, maybe soften up the Queen. If he can, shoot down some drones, but only in a situation where he can escape. Then, shortly after that, he sends the Marines with it in this very deadly timed attack.
I would love this game from Xenio to see some Slayer's Men action, you know, just go like mass Baneling Zergling all game long with upgrades. I think that might be a great idea right now because he does have that risky expand. I think he has to be ultra mobile and aggressive and defensive, like just do everything at once, kind of. And the only way you can afford that is that style. So we'll have to see. But he's making some roaches. His lair is almost done, so we'll have a better idea what tech he's choosing in a moment. Has that extra macro hatchery going off in his main.
Banelings are out. I think Zerg is just going to try to outdo his opponent with a pretty solid unit combo. We do have siege tank or siege mode and siege tanks on the way.
Looks like he is going to go Roach Bane. And a lot of Zergs do prefer that on this map. Sometimes what you can do is as Terran is coming out to take the third, that's when they're weakest. And that's when we saw Coca hit before. And if you just go land Zergling Banes, like with speed and everything, it can be quite nice.
Here comes a drop, and he's going to discover this expansion and probably be a little bit pissed.
Yeah, sick feeling in your stomach, man.
He's got that expansion. He's probably had that for a while. How long has he had that? Why didn't I scout there? I had the Blue Flame Hellions on the map, yet I didn't do anything about it. Nice Mule Snipe.
And, well, Blue Flame Hellions trying to do some harassment. Roaches
no drone
up.
Kill. No drone kills, rather.
60 drones at 44 SCVs at the moment. Baneling speed, Roach speed on the way. And we're going to see some fancy harassment by Xenio, perhaps. He's getting ready for it. And in the meantime, it looks like...
Nice shot on the Queen.
General, it's a great micro here. Speedlings do come up and chase him away, though.
Now, General has to do a timing attack either right before or right as the gold base finishes.
Oops.
That's going to be his timing moment there. And this is where it's going to be. Interesting location. He's going to go for the closest base. And you know what? I like it. He just gives it up. Xenio says, all right, I'll just go to the gold. That's fine.
Yeah, Jinro's coming over here with a pretty good timing. He doesn't have a lot of units right now. Sending his drones to the gold. That is a great idea, Tasos.
Yeah, just give it up.
And he's at least going to keep Jinro's units over there for a little bit with those spines.
He might even come into this expansion location.
Well, taking out a siege tank. It's no small thing. Might even take out this bunker as well. And Rogue just following up. Suddenly, he's doing some good damage.
And you know what? Genio's so smart. But, all right, man, it's fine. You go ahead and attack the location. I'll take the one location that you are only mining from.
And Jinro falling apart a little bit here. So eager to kill that base, but not leave enough at home.
That's going to be tough to recover from.
It is. In fact, right now, it's 38 SCVs to 65 drones. Xeno has the gold base.
And I think suddenly Jinro realizes, oh my god, what he might have realized during that battle, there's nothing even mining at this base.
And in fact, yeah, that's...
This base is a giant paperweight. And Xeno's expanding again at the upper left.
Oh, and the Roach is still killing off some more SCVs, keeping that count down. We do have another base going down for Xeno.
Medivac drop coming here.
Has a couple blue flame hellions in there. He's going to want to take that pretty seriously. Doesn't want to lose all those drones in his main.
I honestly don't know if the medevac should be out here. I don't know how much damage you're going to do. Then again, I guess I don't really know what else Jinro can do right now.
Well, I think he's thinking, well, there's no mutas yet. Well, little does he know, there's 12 on the way, but no mutas yet. I should be flying around with this and doing something.
Probably get a Thor out here pretty soon.
Xeno's taking the map right now, man. He's up 50% in supply. He's got 157 to 105 supply. Taking another base.
I wonder if actually pushing, I don't know, you know, the fact that Jinro didn't scout that location, the center right, earlier enough, even though he had Blue Flame Hellions, is sort of unforgivable. The whole point of Blue Flame Hellions, or one of the advantages, is how much of the map you can control.
Yeah. Well, you know, with those mutas flying in, killing his drop off, Jinro, I think, is going to be in not a very good mood right now. He realizes, now I'm confined to my base even more. Xeno has to be nearing a max, which he is, and just taking the map. So Jinro right now, his Marines do not even have plus one. He just started it.
I like this. Watch. When Jinro leaves, he's going to send these mutas in here. He's going to send these Zerglings over here, too, to try to carve open that bottom right location.
Yeah.
Guys, remember, Jinro's on two bases.
Yeah.
And this is almost late game.
Yeah, this is a very bad spot for Jinro Basis. And as Jinro looks like he wants to go up towards the gold area, Xeno says, fine, go up there. I'm rolling in here, and I'm going to see what I can kill. And draws him back in.
This is how a good Zerg player plays. He makes sure his opponent is always going back home as the Zerg gets bigger, stronger, faster, however the Daft Punk song goes.
Utilizing that John's common knowledge hallway.
Yep.
You know, even though you know about it, just like everyone does,
it's still good.
A lot of damage.
It might be just as good as my secret hallway. And you can see Jinro probably not going to push out. Maybe just going to go for this these rocks over here. Take the gold. Probably can't, but try to drag this out into the late game. Oh, man, so nice.
Yeah, fancy footwork on those mutas, despite not having feet, taking out a few siege tanks.
Wow.
That's inspiring. Inspiration for you, Tasis.
You just see me when I play Protoss and make my Colossus wear tap dancing shoes. So it gives my opponent a little bit of an advantage.
He has ballet shoes on. Like, just go straight down. 21 okay. veins being morphed.
If I'm seeing this situation correctly, he may just let him take this location and right-click on the planetary or orbital, in this case, of the Banelings.
You know, right now, Jinro, he's... He's just going to go in there. Not enough siege tanks left. And he's just crashing into everything, Tasis. I do not know if Jinro is going to be able to live through this.
I don't think he will.
You know, he might kill off a ton of SCVs at least. You know, those siege tanks look like they may kill
this
off.
This is a frustrating feeling as Terran because it's a situation where you're just never able to get that part out of your base. And every time you do, you're punished for it. And that's it. GG.
Oh, heartbreak, Tasis. Jinro going down to Code A. Xeno staying in Code S. A Pyrrhic victory for Xeno, not one to send his friend.
Xeno handled it. Was quite a variety of games. And, you know, I have to say, I think Jinro was a little bit too reliant on bunker rushing to get ahead, you know. And Xeno deserves the win. I like Junior. I wanted to see him advance, you know, he's in Code A now, so there's always a chance he can push through that way.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he's better than
we've already seen, like MVP and people like that go down to Code A and
it's
bounce back. So
great players go down there, man.
Yeah.
It happens. Slayer's Boxer MVP in Code A.
Yeah.
Seriously.
So, I mean, we'll see. Thank you guys all for tuning in. It's been a real treat. And, of course, so we still have another foreigner here in the up-and-down matches.
Yeah, Huck.
Liquid Huck, teammate of Jinro.
Of course.
So you never know what to expect. But interesting games. I do like Xenio taking the center-right location. Sometimes.
Yeah, I like that. And he had it up long enough. And then Jinro lost the game when he overcommitted to killing that so quickly. That's always... You get a bad feeling when you see something like
that. Well, it's like
you're like, I do have to kill it.
You're like, oh,
but when you're killing it, you're weak.
Right.
You're weak to other things happening. So,
yeah, there's really just not much more to say. We're going to go ahead and throw up the match results on screen for you guys.
We do have up to Code S. MVP Keen stays in Code S. Trickster San is going to be going down to Code A. Same goes with poor Liquid Jinro, while Xenio and Koka, two Zergs, going up to Code S.
So it's been an exciting day today, the first day of the up and down matches. And I got to say, MVP Keen and Zenix Koka, two Code A players, proving that they're already ready to be in Code S. It's very exciting to see, you know, the landscape of players change and transform as the metagame of StarCraft 2 changes and transforms. Now, tomorrow we, of course, have more up and down matches. It's going to be TSL Alive from Code A. We've seen him before. Very good player. Zenix Bion, he's been with us since the start. Great player. Check Prime. That guy's been with us since the beta. And, of course, in Group D, Slayers Leung, OGS MC. I'm sure you guys remember him, the Kratos Protoss. And Hongan Prime, that's going to be a very interesting group.
That is a really interesting group. Couple storylines tomorrow, man. Will Czech be knocked out of Code S?
Yeah.
He's been around forever.
It's going to be interesting.
Then, yeah, between Ryung, Hongan, and MC, I don't think that Ryung is going down to Code A. I have a gut feeling. This guy played so well.
He's good.
He's really, really good. Something else.
And yeah.
I mean, TVP, not his best matchup, but still, I don't know, man. He's like one of these really rising stars.
Well, I'm curious to see what the results are going to be. It will either be casted by Artosis and myself or Doa and Moltrap. I think so. We have to get some scheduling stuff sorted out, so we don't know for sure right now. We do apologize for that. But the Code S finals under that is going to be at Taegu, the Expo Center. We're going to go back to Taegu, Artosis.
Yeah.
It's going to be another road trip.
Us. We have missed Taegu. I can't wait. It's going to be a lot of fun.
So maybe you're from Busan and you want to, you know, take a little road trip up to Taegu. It's not as far as Seoul, obviously, or Incheon.
It's really close.
And, nice city. Or, you know, if you're, maybe you're in Taegu or in the surrounding area. Or maybe you're a rich baller and you just want to fly in and
on
land.
On your golden jet?
Yeah, on your golden jet.
Land right at Daegu at the Expo Center.
Your golden helicopter, come down on a rope, land on top of the building.
If you do that, let Taegu us know. Helipad. We want to check out your golden helicopter.
We need to ally our turrets to you so that they don't shoot you down. But, come down there. We try to get a chance to shake the hands of the people that are at the event.
And I borrow my spore crawler so it doesn't get you.
That's right. So for Artosis and myself, Tastosis, today's been the GSL. We'll see you guys again soon.